There is a growing number of Christian pastors who no longer believe in God. This is not a conspiracy or a few isolated cases. I recently listened to a popular podcast, Premier Christian Radio, which addressed this issue and was titled Number 15, A Pastor Losing His Faith Writes In. Scrolling back to almost 45 years ago, Dr. Gerald J. Judd surveyed a group of these faithless pastors and wrote a book on this subject. And today, roughly 50 years later, the Clergy Project, which is a safe place for Christian pastors to share their lack of belief, has 582 members. I too was once a devout believer, so this does not surprise me at all. The closer you draw to this God, the more you become aware of how it behaves exactly as though it does not exist. I have also suspected that those who study the Bible the most will not become more faithful, but the opposite, more aware of its issues. We are also now living in a new information age, and the older pastors are all dying out. Such an uncomfortable trend now seems unavoidable, whereas many pastors who have lost faith are continuing to lead churches in prayer and preach from a book they no longer believe in. The one thing we can all understand is that for these pastors, walking away from their church will come at a very high price. Most would rather fake it. One of these pastors who left the church completely, Jason Eden, said, "Full-time clergy or religious business leaders who have come to the realization that their faith is a sham risk financial hardship for their families if they come clean to their followers or customers. If most of your friendships, family relationships, and even your marriage are based on this common set of beliefs, you risk losing it all." I also suspect that some of the world's most popular Christian speakers on apologetics are very aware of how weak their arguments are. But the occupation comes with a position of esteem and wealth. The very radio broadcast that I tuned into is earning vast amounts of money preaching on apologetics and selling books. There is far more support and revenue to be made arguing for Christianity than against. Christians feel as if they will be rewarded by God if they send money into these institutions. I wonder how many of these speakers, some who are even scholars, are primarily in it for the easy money. I will also add to this a very interesting trend going on within modern Christianity today. A lot of churches, especially the big mega churches that bring in millions of dollars, have sermons that altogether avoid Bible study and sound more like self-help lectures. Perhaps this is a sign that pastors are trying to distance themselves from any problems accompanied with the Bible, certainly not wanting to arouse any tough questions. And then, of course, you have televangelism, where these preachers, in my opinion, seem completely insincere as they scam millions of lonely, vulnerable, and poor people around the world in order to live a life of luxury and afford jet airplanes. Are these successful preachers actually believing in the Bible? My best guess, probably not so much. The bigger question here is, will this trend spell out the beginning of the end for Christianity? In my opinion, it is a certainty and only a short matter of time. I do not believe anybody will ever see Jesus return from a cloud, but rather fade into an ancient world of Bronze Age mythology. And these once famous religious con men will be reduced to a local used car salesman. And this will be a good thing for humanity. Stay strong and wise, my friends.
I don't believe in masquerades. I don't believe that you're okay. I don't believe that God will save. Only you can solve your problems. I don't care what they sold you. They are not here to hold you. Don't believe it for a moment. Don't believe them for a moment.
Stairway to Reason is on a mission to help wake up this world from religious fables. We are not a copy and paste page. We are content creators. We work very hard and are full of passion and sincerity. Become a private member by clicking the support button right at the bottom of this video. Thank you so much, friends. We need you.